What's up, friends? Chalk here, and welcome back to Subnautica. Okay, so it is 478,000 degrees here in Melbourne, Australia today. So I've got two fans going. I checked it, so it didn't sound too bad. But if you can hear some fans in the background, I apologize. But there's no way I could play upstairs in my study without some fans on. I also have my giant can of non-sponsored V. Which I think is an Australian-only company. Might be New Zealand as well, I don't know. It's basically like a better Red Bull. Well, I like it better than Red Bull. Because I slept like shit last night because it was so hot. Anyway, let's get to it. What were we doing? We had just made this, just for the meantime, so that we could make a base, right? However, when we go in here, you see we're losing oxygen, and we have no power. So maybe if we give it power, we'll also get oxygen. I can't remember. So let's have a look at what we can build, right? We might even... Oh, no. I was going to say we might even need to scan a blueprint for solar panels. But nope, there they are. So we need one more quartz, which is easy done, actually. So let's go... Wait, was it quartz? Hang on, was it quartz or gold? Ah, shit, it's just quartz. That's fucking even easier. Also, I did some tweaks in between episodes from yesterday to today. Hopefully it runs a bit smoother with the whole FPS thing. If it does not, then I will make more tweaks. But I'm hoping it's better. Although I'm already noticing we're at 50 frames there, so maybe it's not better actually. Shit. But again, if it gets really, really bad, I'll just pause the episode and fix it. Or try and fix it. Okay, here's the quartz. We're good. Done. Let's hook up some oxygen. Okay, we're good. And let us make a solar panel. Which is new and improved from the last solar panels I saw. I assume it's the same and you just like dunk it on here. Just like that. And that should link to our base. One would hope. There we go. So let's go in.
Power restored.
And do we have oxygen in here now? Yeah, okay. Nice. So the power also gives oxygen. You can see there we have 2 out of 50 power, 3 out of 50 power. I think the more like stuff you build, so if you build another thingy, solar panel, it would go to like 4 out of 100, I believe. Also, when we use a fabricator or something, it uses power. So you kind of want to deck up your power in your base. What is this? Okay, so we can pump... Okay, nice. Interior, a ladder. Fabricator, wiring kit, computer chip. You know what? The first thing we're going to worry about... Aquarium glass. We should probably get an aquarium. And a sign. Okay, a couple of... The first thing we're going to worry about is maybe getting a fabricator, actually. So what was that? Wiring kit and a computer chip. Okay, wiring kit and a computer chip. Just so that we don't have to keep swimming back here to get to the fabricator. But the main thing we want is a scanning tool. Wiring kit. Wiring kit. Wiring kit. And a computer chip. So computer chip is silver ore. That's annoying because we struggled to get that. So, okay, so 3 silver ore is basically what we're after. What do we need to make a scanner? A battery. That's piss. We can do that right now. What do we need? 2 mushrooms, which are abundantly everywhere in this biome, so... One of you. Okay. Oh! Look how fucking awesome that looks. The water effects and everything, and then, like, the double moon. Or planet, or I don't know what's going on. I assume it's double moon. Why not? Alright, let's get our scanner on. Tools. Oh wait, we need to make the battery first. Adur. I also slept with the fan on last night, with no sheets, and now I'm a bit sniffly this morning. So I may have given myself a cold. So I do apologize about that as well. Okay. Let us scan, make a scan at least. Alright, fuck yeah. Alright, so we have the basis of what we want now. Let's change the scanner to 1. Let's change the habitat builder to 5, and let's make this knife No, we'll make the knife one and we'll make the scanner two. No, we won't. We'll make the scanner one and the knife two. I'm just thinking about what I'm going to use more often. And the scanner is definitely going to be used more often. Okay, so here we go. We have a scanner. So now we can scan basically everything. Go up to this table coral or whatever this is. Red coral. Scan. No? Okay, you used to be able to scan everything. Acid mushroom. There we go. Okay, we couldn't scan that, but we can scan this. Acid mushroom. Scan. We've done it. Press tab to view. Okay, so you get like lore on stuff as well. We're not going to go through everything, otherwise we'll be here literally forever. But anything cool that we find or anything new that we find that I hadn't seen before or whatever, we'll go through. But just for, you know, to show it off, let's do it. A common spore-bearing fungi species with developed defense mechanisms. The flesh contains a highly acidic compound, which leaches into the water if the outer skin is penetrated. Fluctuations in the local water pressure may also cause it to shrink. It's not clear which predator species necessitated such extreme countermeasures, but the acid mushroom numbers suggest it has successfully deterred most of them. Assessment, inedible applications in battery fabrications. So it does tell you like what you can use it for and stuff. Okay, let's get out of here and get some air. So it said that it puts out a poison thing if the skin's ruptured. So if we don't pick it up and we cut it, is it gonna like do nasties? Yeah, shit it is too. Fantastic. And we got some spores there. As you saw. We'll probably get rid of them. That's for the farming update. So where you can like go around the world basically and get stuff. And then plant it. And then so like if you've got stuff from different biomes or you want to keep replenishing something, you can just farm it and get more and more and more of it. But we don't need that right now.
Dehydration detected.
Okay, let's get ourselves some water. Where do we leave it? I think we left it in this little thing. We could probably make a locket inside of our that shitty base down there now as well. Be much better than this stupid storage thing. Because this locker kind of sucks ass, to be honest. No, I don't want to, because it's so hard to get into. Open, there we go. Water. Two of them. Two of your finest waters. Okay, drink that.
Drink that.
We could probably do with getting some more water and maybe some food as well. These guys are really good to eat, but they're fast, so sometimes it could be hard to catch them. But now we have fins, that shouldn't be too much of a problem. Okay, so now that we've got a scanner, the game opens up a lot. Like, a lot. So what we want to do now is we just want to swim around and find stuff like this. Right, and you go down here, and these are called fragments. They look a bit different than last time I played. Last time they were actually kind of hard to see in, like, if they were sitting in a bed of, like, kelp and coral and stuff like this. They were really small, and they kind of looked like the things that were hitting on the wall to get titanium. But now they look bigger, which is good, and it kind of shows what's inside it as well, which is nice. So, we scan this. Sea glide fragment. Press tab to view. Okay, sea glide. The Sea Glide is a personal transportation system. Okay, let's maybe... Oh, you can swim up while you're doing this. Fantastic. Sea Glide is a personal transportation device designed to use in for use in oceanic environments. Capable of speeds of up to 10 meters per second in standing water, displays basic topographical data for aid in charting cave systems. Replaceable battery. Okay. So, where is our blueprints? There we go. Sea Glide. We have one of two. So if we find one more sea glide fragment, we can then go and make that bad boy. So let us do exactly that. Let's just go like, swim around. We'll just collect some stuff while we're out here, like quartz, and hopefully we can come and find some silver ore as well, because that would be good. How much bag space do we have? Not a heap, but titanium's handy because it's used for basically everything. So let's grab that. Here's a new enemy, I guess, or like hostile thing. Oh, fuck off, dude. Whoa, he's like spazzing out. Piss off. I'll cut you. Let me cut you. Okay, apparently I can't cut you. I think they're called sand sharks. Like, they dig underground. That one's got like fucking predator blood on him. Like, I don't know. He had all like highlighter stuff on him. Let's see if we can get in here and get some stuff without these guys cracking the shits. Is this something or is this just rock? think that's just rock. Okay. Some salt here. Oh shit, we're gonna get fragged. Yeah, he's got like... Can we scan you? Let's try and scan you, right? If you come close, we'll scan you. Limestone chunk. Copper ore. Okay.
30 seconds.
30 seconds. So, this might be like the start of a new biome or something. Where it's a little bit more aggressive, I guess. Maybe. Let's get rid of everything so we swim a bit faster. And we'll probably just end up scanning like basically everything as we get to it. Because if you watch my Bioshock thing, like scanning stuff, taking photos of stuff, researching things, like I'm all about it. I love it. Let's scan this little dick. I hate these things. They're annoying. Also, they're like impossible to scan apparently. Oi, come back. Stop it. Alright, we got it. Did we kill it? I think we killed it. Nope, it's alive. Okay, let's scan. Creep vine? Getting all the lore. So, let's just read a few more of these, right? And see what lore it does actually give us. Kelp species concentrating light. Okay, this is not so useful. Predators. Hoverfish, eye, rabbit, ray, peeper. Assessment. Vital alien resource. Edible. Medicinal. Construct applications. So this is really what we want to look at. This, oh no, this does help actually. This stems for the textiles such as rope and bandages. Okay, what's it say about this guy? Small aggressive specimen, 94% muscle, 4% kinetic, connective tissue, 2% brain. likely indiscriminate when hunting, anything injured is fair game. Second pair of eyes. But according to calculations, creatures up to 100 times the biter's body weight can succumb to a focused assault. Avoid large group, try not to bleed. This is fucking awesome. They've done a lot of work. Great. Love it. Okay. Let's scan some salt. Nope, you can't scan salt. It's fine. Can we scan limestone chunk? We sure can. Okay, what's that say? Limestone outcrops. Titanium and copper source. But okay, so maybe the silver came from not a limestone. Titanium and copper deposits. Closer analysis reveals the stone around the metal is hardened against erosion. Okay. So we need to make sure, we need to pay attention to where we actually get silver from, because then if we need silver, we can just avoid limestone altogether. Although we should probably just pick it up anyway, because it's useful. Anyway, let's grab some more food. Let's put that away so we can actually catch up to this guy. We missed him. Okay, we got it. Oh, and there's another hoverfish. Come here. I remember your name.
New creature discovered.
Titanium. No, that's not right. Hoverfish. Edible. Okay. Yeah. Like I said, they're not all brilliant. Copper ore. Sandstone. Gold. Okay, maybe it's sandstone. That's good to distinguish. That's good. I like it. Okay, sandstone. Silver and gold. Alright, brilliant. Is that silver? Oh, oxygen. Shit. Okay, so sandstone gives us silver and gold. Limestone gives us copper and titanium. That's good. It's very good. We should probably get some bladderfish as well, so we can make some air. Air sac fish. They were around. They were around base, I think. We'll scan this this guy as well. Rabbit ray. They're non-hostile. I think they're just pretty. I don't think they do anything. But we will scan. Come on. Takes so long. Okay. Rabbit ray. Poisonous flesh. Large and without other defense mechanism. The rabbit ray, which is super cute by the way, appears to have... It looks like a fucking Pokemon. Evolved poisonous flesh to ward off predators. Main method of steady transportation. Grass and kelp assessment. Edible, but harmless. Yeah, so it's just there for pretties. Which I appreciate. I love the pretties. Okay, is this that wreck that we found before? I think it is. This is where we got that radiation suit, which was super handy. This wasn't in trying to get out of a freaking closed thing. This wasn't in the game when I played, so you had to like make the radiation suit yourself, and it was a bit stressful. All right, we are looking for you, bladderfish, or whatever your name is. Is it bladderfish? Yeah, bladderfish. Probably need one more of them, actually. We're pretty low on water. Oh, hang on, we have a scanny scan. Or is that the scanny scan we've already done? Yes, it is. Okay. Oh, right, so it's not the box that we scanned, it's the actual seat. Ah, it's fucking even better. Holy shit. Yeah, because like I said, the last time it was just a small box, a small white box, and it kind of blended in with everything else. That was the actual sea glide itself, but inside of that box, and once we scanned it, the actual sea glide itself disappeared, which is pretty amazing. Okay, there's an egg there. Don't really need it. We can scan it though. No, we can't. Can we scan you? Can't scan any of this stuff. We've already scanned the acid mushrooms. Okay, bladderfish. Where you at? We don't need garryfish. They're terrible. Oh, here's another sea glide fragment, maybe. Or is that just salvage? No, that's just salvage. Alright, well, I think we just need to head back and get some form of sustenance, right? We can always get more. Plenty more fish in the sea, as they say. And it's quite an apt description here. Okay, quickly, let's turn all of the salvage into titanium, because we have a buttload of it. Magnesium. Don't need any more of that at the moment. Let's cook up some water. I think that's all we've got. It is all we've got. Let's cook up a firm, low-fat reptilian fish. Fuck yeah. Let's cook him up. Probably cook up peeper because they're worth good eats. Consider disgusting the flavor unsafe. I missed it. Probably need one more, I would think. And then we'll make a cured boomerang. Just to have on us, just in case. Okay, let's eat all that stuff before it goes bad. Okay. Cooked peeper. Done. Cooked peeper. Done. Yeah, there are so good eats. Hoverfish. Water. Nice. And then we got the two cubed things. We need to get rid of these. And we have a crap ton of titanium. Titanium! No, I won't. I won't. Creepvine cluster. That doesn't seem to go off. So we can keep that there. Probably put some gold away. We'll keep some titanium just in case we need to build something. We might go make a locker in our base. Because that seems like a good idea, right? We got some silver ore. We need a bit more silver ore. You know what? We should make... we should find, like, one of those big coral tubes. Here we go. This one. Perfect. It's even underground. This will be our bin. Oh, there's another scannable, I think. Let's do that quickly first. Two, in fact. Alright, we're going to get a sea glide out of this. We are going to get nothing. And nothing. Can we open it? So, the fragments aren't necessarily in boxes. It's just that one was in a box. Okay. This is a wreck, though. So, let's explore this. Because it, like, apart from anything else, it's fucking cool. Pick up some quartz, why not? Because you can get, you can find, like, cool stuff in wrecks. And, like, yeah. Can we actually get in it, is the problem. Well, is the question, more than the problem. Pick up a boomerang on the way, why not? I don't think we can. I don't think this door opens. No. So, I think this is just, again, for looks. What about this? Is there anything in this? Oh, there we go. Perfect. We have a sea glide now. Well, we have access to a sea glide. Hooplint. Unlock. Okay. Acquired. Whatever. Same shit. So we can definitely go back and take a look at that. Let's just see if there's anything else in these boxes. The box with the sea glide in it seemed to be a lot smaller. So. Okay. We needed bladderfish. There you are. No! Come here. Yeah, there we go. Should probably scan all these new fish as well. Oh god, am I going to black out? No. Yeah. If you die, you just respawn, basically, but you lose everything you have on you. You don't lose the blue prints and stuff that you've scanned or whatnot. What was that? Wait. You just, like, lose everything on your person, effectively. Salt, metal salvage, scan. Is that just going to say it gives you titanium, right? You know what? Fuck it. Limestone we've already done, so that's going to be titanium or copper. Copper it is. Copper is much better than titanium, in the fact that you can get titanium from the salvage, whereas you can only get copper from those things. So anytime you get copper from those things, it's good. Okay, we keep going in between biomes or whatever, and the music keeps like stopping or something. I'm not too sure what's going on there. Or maybe it's not going in between biomes. Maybe the music's just shitting itself. Remember though, guys, that this is a this is still in the beta. It's not being fully released until May this year. So it's still quite a few months where they can fix some stuff like the frame rates and music bugs and stuff like that. So it's not perfect. It's bloody good, but it's not perfect. So, you know, anytime I see people in the forums and stuff, or just online reviews and whatever, people just like trashing early access games and stuff, sometimes it's warranted, because sometimes some early access games are just trashed and they shouldn't release it in the state it's in. But at the same time, it's their early access for you to support it to get better. Ah, fuck, self-charging power cell. Shit, yeah. And that's no longer bugged. Awesome. Yeah, so I'm not too harsh on games like that. Deployables. Sea Glide. We need a battery, easy. Lubricant and copper wire. Okay, lubricant is... Create Vine Cluster. That's easy. Copper wire was what? Was it copper wire? Copper wire. Oh, we can make copper wire right now. Okay, let's just make sure it was actually copper wire. It was. Okay. So, copper wire. I think the Sea Glide takes up a shit ton of space in inventory though, so we may not end up using it for too long. As soon as we get our Sea Glide, oh man, the game take, like, so when we started, it was basically like, rummage around until we get a base where we can go inside. That's like step one, done. Step two is in our playthrough effectively, is get the scanner and go around scanning stuff and getting blueprints, done. Next thing is getting like the Sea Glide, which is, I won't spoil it if you don't know what it is, but once you get that, that's when the game starts basically. So this is all like tutorially kind of, you know, early game, like getting you used to mechanics and stuff. Oh man, when we get the Sea Glide, it's going to be so good. Okay, what was it else? Lubricant and a battery. Okay, battery we need, so we need creep vine clusters. How much inventory space do we have? Fuck all. Oh, that's right. We're gonna make our bin. Let's do that as well. First of all, let's make some water. Let's make three waters, please. Damn it. Like, they could add in here, if you had multiple things, you know, you could click filter water and then it could come up with like a thing where you could click like plus 3, 4, 5 or whatever if you wanted to make multiples or something. It's not a big deal, but it's just stuff like that. Like, I'm sure that stuff will come. They're just getting like the mechanics and everything in the game right. Alright, we are good to go. Look at this. Fucking fantastic. First aid kit. Let's use it, because these replenish. At least they used to. I hope that's still the case. Okay, we needed creep vine clusters. Was that it? I've already forgotten. My brain is, like, my memory is so bad. Battering lubricant. Yeah, oh, and mushrooms. Okay, easy. Easy peasy. We scan this thing. Shuttlebug. I actually want to read what it says about this, because these things appear to do absolutely nothing. It might just be another thing like the rabbit ray. It's just pretty. Shuttlebug. A Judabug. A common scavenger at the base of the food chain. Mouthpart. Small enough to be non-threat to even small organisms. This creature is clearly adapted to feed on the waste product of the ecosystem around it. Nice. So it's like a underwater demon looking fucking dung beetle. Three mandibles. Used to orientate themselves when drifting. To filter through. Okay, three legs. Assessment. Harmless. Yeah, so it's just a prettiness. Okay. Let's get... Ooh, blue palm. Again, if I cut blue palm, I'll show it, actually. Yeah, it's just a saying about it. If I cut this, I'm going to get a seed. Where is it? Blue palm seed? There it is. And then we can farm that later. But we'll get there. We'll get there. Okay, so that's done. And now we just need creep vines. Which are over here, well, generally surrounding us. So imagine that we're in the center of a circle, so, like the outskirts of a circle basically are these creep lines, or at least in some directions. Maybe it's like a semicircle or something, but they're like, you don't have to venture far from your base to find some, which is good. Okay, here's another new type of fish, except this one's in a school, so you can't actually pick it up. It's just there for pretty. But it is a, this one. Hoopfish.
New creature discovered.
Yeah. Okay. Creep bone. Give me all the things. Oh, we could probably scan, we'll just take like a heap of these, right? Or are we full? We are full. We only got one. Really? Okay, let's drop that. We are actually pretty full. We need... Fuck that off as well. What do we need? We needed like four? Okay. When you drop stuff, it still drops in little boxes. So that's obviously not implemented yet. That's funny. I want more. Two, three. Have we got room? We've got room for one more. Nice. We could probably scan the reef backs as well, which is... Oh, we haven't found a reef back yet. Never mind. Spoilers. We could probably scan the gastropods. That's what I was gonna, is what I meant to say. If we can find one. They were the dugong looking things with poisonous ball sacks on their back that like shoot poisonous jizz at you. Okay, I think we have everything we need to acquire the sea glide. And we're gonna run out of oxygen. Okay, good. If we keep the fish, let's try something, right? Because we have a hoopfish and we have a boomerang on us. If we just hold them in an inventory, like, because if we cook them without curing them, they're going to go off. But if we just hold them forever, will they die? I don't know. Let's find out. Okay, lube. Yes. Brilliant. We've made a giant, giant bottle of lube that would last you quite the amount of time, actually. And then was that it? And a battery. That's right. So this part of the game can be, like, remembering what's what can be a bit of a drag. Like, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know how they could improve that. There could be a way. Like, for instance, if you wanted to go to deployables and you wanted to make the sea glide, it's like, you need a battery, a lubricant, a copper wire, and a titanium. If you had all the parts to that, but instead of manually going and building the battery, building the lubricant, building the copper wire, you could just click this and it'll come up saying, do you want to spend like two mushrooms and a titanium, whatever it is, on a battery? And you just go, yes. Do you want to spend, rather than remembering what's there, going into the other menu, da 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 da. I don't know. That just seems like an easier way of doing things to me. Okay, sea glide. Let's do it. So this thing will look semi-familiar. I mean, these things do exist in the real life, so. The sea glide will increase your effective exploration range. For your safety, please pack supplies for long journeys and always stay within 5 kilometers of the nearest life pod or habitat. I'll do what I want. Yeah, it does take up quite the amount of room, actually. But if we put this on, say, 3, these type of things do exist in real life. Obviously not with the maps and stuff, although maybe they do, I don't know. But now we can swim like a fuck ton quicker. And it surveys the lands and stuff. So it was saying like when you go into caves and shit, you know, you can find your way out and stuff. Which is pretty cool. It does use quite a bit of battery though. So unless we need it, we won't use it. And honestly, you probably won't use it that much because as soon as we get the Seamoth, like it's all over. Okay, I want to go in here.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Thanks, Stutz. I want to make a locker. We need some glass. Crap. We have like... Oh, a wall locker or a locker? Fuck, a wall locker. All about the wall lockers. Let's put one here. Alright, and then let's... Can we do another one? Oh, shit, yeah. And another one here. Alright. Like I said, we will make this base a lot better. For the moment, it does the job. And then can we make a... fabricator? No, we need a wiring kit and a computer chip and 2 titanium. Okay, we'll work on that next. We'll work on this next. Let's rename this to, like, titanium. And then we'll rename this, like, stuff. Right? In here. we'll put titanium, of which we have none. In here, we'll put stuff, of which we have heaps. Crit by cluster, off you go. Quartz, 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 lead, salt, 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 silver ore. We'll make it like an ore one as well, maybe. For now, it's fine though. We'll keep these fish, because I want to test that out. We've got the cured fish, so we've got stuff for it, and we need everything else. Okay, so that's opened up our inventory quite a bit, actually, which is nice. Apparently, we've got 5 new blueprints. A blueprint for a fish, which is kind of funny. Databank. Hoop fish. Edible. Okay, log. Sea glider increase your lubricant is successful. Da, 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 da. Okay, that's fine. Also, maybe we'll make an aquarium. Or maybe you need a large aquarium for those eggs to hatch. We'll test it. What do you need for an aquarium? 4 glass and 2 titanium. Okay, so that's quite a bit of quartz. 8 quartz. But we'll do it. We'll do it. Why not? We should also probably think about, like, expanding this a little bit. So maybe we'll, like, put a thing here. We have no titanium on us. But we could put, like, a... owl compartment, maybe? And, like, spin it over here? That seems like a cool idea. For now... What was that? Ah, shit, this has a power to it. Yeah, okay. Alright, we were doing, we wanted to get a fabricator. That's right. In the base. For which we need a wiring kit, a computer chip, and titanium. Okay, I can't remember what a wiring kit and whatever else was, computer chip, so let's go check that. Wiring kit and computer chip. I'm pretty sure it needs silver, though. I think we went through that before, actually. Wiring kit. Computer chip is silver ore, which is fine. The coral sample is nothing. And wiring kit. Yeah, so we need 3 silver ore. Okay, that's fine. Let's do it. We can use our sea glide to get around a bit faster now, which is cool. Let's go, like, out a little bit, because we might find more of those different outcrops a bit further out. Here's some salt. Can we do stuff while this is equipped? Can we pick this up? No, you have to put it away. Okay, no, you don't necessarily, because that wasn't something we could pick up. But you can. Okay, that's fantastic. Fuck off, you stupid shark. Why are you, like... Why have you been hit by a predator? I don't get it. Or why is a predator bled all over you? Cool. I mean, it's not the most hostile thing in the world. He just doesn't want us, like, up in his grill, that's all. Take that. Here's a sand shark egg. I know that. Ow! Okay. Never mind. I went near his egg and he cracked his shits. Oh, is this another new fish? Oh. We're doing it. Doing all the new fish. Speed fish, come here. Surely you could, like, just catch it. Like, just go like this and then just hold it in your hand. But no. Okay, let's go over both the speed fish and the shark, right? Because we got new intel. Might be useful. If we can ever get to the surface. Having those air tanks is fucking brilliant, isn't it? Holy crap. Okay, short range scan suggests that this grassy biome, so that was where we were with the sand sharks, supports extensive biodiversity both above and below the surface. Okay, that's amazing. Sand shark, here we go. A slow, powerful predator digs burrows in the sand and ambushes its prey. Herbivores, up to twice its size, so we're definitely under twice its size, that's for sure. Use caution in sandy biomes. Okay, easy. Threat level. Oh, it's even got a threat level. Holy crap. That's fucking awesome. Speed fish. Threat level. Nothing. Edible. Okay, I don't know how the hell this thing does anything. I mean, look, it's got one eye looking to the sky. I mean, you would just get fragged from underneath so bad. It would just... It'd have to be like a, like octopus or something like that, that, you know, basically just lived on the ground floor and then only swam when it needed to. But, I mean, look, you could easily come from underneath this thing. Oh, shit. Really? We were just on the surface. Right, here's a lot of shit we can probably find some scannables in, which is good. There's the gastropods, which we want to go scan as well. Okay, let's get this out so we can, like, zoom down here. Okay, anything? Let's get our scanner out in preparation. No, nothing. Okay, let's get the scanner not out. Pick up some salt, because why not? Have we scanned a Gary fish yet? Probably haven't. Okay, there's a stupid fucking piranhas around, which is irritating. Haven't scanned a thresher either, so we can go and do that. I think this is just for looks, maybe. Yeah, it's looking that way. Okay, what is this? Nope, this is fine. What's in here? Well, the aquarium was like 4 glass or something, so we'll pick up all the quartz we can. Salt does seem handy for curing food, but we do have quite a bit of it. Probably don't need to pick up that much more salt for the moment being. Some eggs. Gastropod. Alright, here we go. Let's scan you, fat man. You fucking ball sacks. Stop convulsing! Just scan, dude! It takes so long! Alright, we've done it. Slow moving life form capable of filling the water with a poisonous and corrosive jizz. Filtration system, blah, blah, blah. Assessment, use caution. Okay, that's fine. So, it seems like we can pick this up. Oh crap, oxygen. There was definitely an option to pick up those balls. Or at least I think there was. Okay, did any balls survive? I don't believe they did. Okay, here we go. We picked up a ball. And then we got poisoned. What does this ball do? A gassy acid pod. Okay, we don't particularly need that. And we dropped it and got ourselves poisoned immediately. So that was well worth it. Alright. Let's keep doing our thing. We don't need more salt. Limestone, titanium. I mean, titanium's always useful, like I said. Oh! Bit of a frame drop there. Okay, there's heaps of shit in here. Probably do with building a torch as well. For when we get into the darkness. Okay, this wasn't a bad little cave. Got quite a few ingredients or materials out of this. Pick up some more quartz. Yes, we do have a bit of quartz in our locker inside of our shitty little base as well. Okay, we've got the Gary fish. Okay, so far we've got nothing that we came out for, which is a bit disappointing actually. We need to find more of that sandstone, so yeah, I think we need to venture out a little bit further. But what we can do is, we can go back to our base. Wherever it may- oh, frames, come on, dude. Oh, I'm gonna have to fix something with that. Let's scan this guy while we're here. Okay, scanning- oh god, just run. Scanning two of them at once, not ideal. Let's go back and get a first aid kit, because that was a bit risky. Okay, the music's bugged again, but that's fine. Okay, remember I just remembered that we can make water with bleach, right? So what does it take to make bleach? Bleach. Common coral... oh, it needs salt, so common coral sample. Let's quickly go get one of them. I assume it's just like... this, maybe? Are you a common coral sample? Giant coral. Wait, picked up carbon. Yeah, okay, sweet. Alright, let's get 3 then. And I'll show you what we're going to use. We're going to use this as our bin, right? So anything we don't want, we're going to chuck down here. What is this? Nothing. Alright. So, what don't we want? We don't want... let's throw away something. Are these fish still alive? They are, okay. So you can just hold fish indefinitely. That's pretty good. Probably don't need three of these, so let's just drop one, right? And then we can always come back and get it, I guess. The only problem is if we, like, dump everything in there, it might, like, fuck up the frames, because, like, it has to reload it every time we come nearby. So maybe that's not the best idea, but we'll see. Okay, let's quickly get a first aid kit and use that. There we go. We could do with some food. Spadefish, why not? We'll keep the cured stuff for when we're out and about. There's no use eating it now when we can just cook fresh stuff. So let's quickly eat them. You and you and you. Okay, now we need some water. So let us make some bleach. Make two because we took two samples with us. Okay, water. Disinfected water. Done. And done. Preparing the day's water ration ahead of time will help you ensure against dehydration and eventual death. It's true. 40 water. I think the other one only gave us 20. So that's, yeah, that's fucking way better. Holy crap. Alright, nice. Last thing we'll do before we call it a day, because we're at 40 minutes, is let's make an extension to this, right? Just so our home is a tiny, tiny bit better. Elk apartment. We want to go, probably want to go this way, right? Okay, let's have a look, see what that did. So we can come in here, oh yeah, look. Then we can like put some more rooms and stuff. We've got the lockers, it's fantastic. So let's just double check. We still need a fabricator. We still need a wiring kit and a computer chip, of which we found no silver. So we're still in the exact same spot as what we were like 10 minutes ago. But we did scan some stuff and do some other things. It's a survival game, it's a slow grind. If you got through it in like 4 seconds, what would be the point, right? So yeah, so much more to come. I hope you guys are enjoying this already, just the two episodes. I am already, like, having huge nostalgia, like, fucking, I love it. I love it so much. Either way, I hope you're enjoying it. As always, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.